Moin moin liebe Retro-Freunde, ich bin's euer Marcel und ihr seid herzlich willkommen hier bei uns auf dem Channel NES-Kommando, heute zu einer etwas spezielleren Runde, ja. Ihr habt schon am Thumbnail gesehen, es geht um ein Interview. Wir haben auf der Gamescom, die ist jetzt zwar schon 3 Monate her, aber trotzdem hat das Ganze einen brandaktuellen Bezug, was wir euch heute zeigen. Wir haben nämlich auf der Gamescom ein NES-Kommando-exklusives Interview mit Cyril Lambert geführt. Das ist der CEO von Dotemu, ne? Einer Firma, die sich darauf spezialisiert hat, Spieleklassiker aus den 80ern, 90ern, frühen 2000ern eben auf heutige Konsolen, Handys, PC und was weiß ich nicht noch zu portieren oder neu umzusetzen. Und ja, was damals dabei rauskam, habt ihr ja gesehen. Die haben nämlich auf der Gamescom Windjammers promotet. Und ja, wir haben damals ein Pressekit bekommen von denen und haben dann nachher, naja, Windjammers kurz verlost. Ihr wisst das noch, ne? Es war richtig geil. Und deswegen habe ich mich heute auch entsprechend Windjammers-mäßig in Schale geschmissen. Dieses Interview zeigen wir euch heute. Das Ganze hat einen brandaktuellen Bezug, ne? Weil morgen passiert etwas, was auch mit Windjammers zu tun hat. Dazu komme ich aber gleich nochmal. Erstmal gucken wir uns das Interview an. Commander Dennis hat für euch die investigativen Fragen gestellt. Das dürft ihr nicht verpassen. Liebe Freunde, Dennis und Cyril Lambert im Interview. Viel Spaß.
Hi everybody, we are here with Cyril Lambert from Dotemu. And yeah, thanks for having us today.
Thanks for coming.
And yeah, we have some questions to ask you. So first of all, maybe you can tell us about yourself and Dotemu.
Okay, so I'm the CEO at Dotemu. Dotemu is a company that specializes in retro gaming. So we bring back games from the 80s, 90s, early 2000s back to the newest platforms, and pretty much all of them, mobile, PC, and console. And we either do it like we do adaptations, straight up adaptations, so we keep the exact same game and we try to do the same experience on new platforms, or we do remakes, and it's either like sequels or like complete remake of existing games.
Yeah, so remakes is a good thing. We very much like your
Wonder Boy,
the Dragon's Trap, and also East Origin that will be coming shortly. So what we would like to know is, what is your involvement in the physical releases of these games?
So basically, before, like, we were focusing on mobile for a long time, so there was no reason to do anything physical. Then we started to do some PC, and now we're full into console, but we're still doing mobile and PC, but we're doing a lot of console games. So there was more opportunities of doing physical editions. But to do physical edition, you need like a certain appeal around the game, like you need like a minimum like success or hype around the game, so that you know that people will be interested in buying them. And also you need like a certain price point. Mm-hmm. So like for example, a 10 euro game, it's not enough to like sell like on physical, or otherwise you would have to put like 30, so it's like 20 euros difference, doesn't make sense. Mm-hmm. So the last two games that we worked on, East Origin and Wonder Boy, they were like right on the spot, like right at the limit, you know, but it was doable. First we started to work with Limited Run Games. They're awesome guys. They're doing awesome collector edition, standard edition from indie games. I love their story as well. And so yeah, they were really interested in working with us. And of course, I mean, for us it was a new thing, so we're like, yeah, let's do it. You know, that would be awesome anyways. Okay. And then from there, we started to get interest from other companies that wanted to do like physical distribution as well, like Arc System Works, that's working with us for the Asian markets. We would like to continue to do that. For that, we need games that you know, have the right fit. Yep. But that's pretty much it. Yeah.
Why are you not doing it yourself? You are a distributor, so why aren't you distributing yourself the physical releases?
So we're not distributing it because ourselves? Because basically, it's really like a different job. So you have to have a lot of experience in that field, knowledge. And we just started, so in many ways we got confused on many things at the beginning when we started to work with Limited Run Game. Was pretty easy because they take care of everything and explain everything, it's easy, but like for other potential partners, we had to like figure out like how it works. It's totally different from the digital market, so we had to learn a lot. And then like it's different, it's risks, you take a lot of risks because you have to produce everything and you have to sell everything, because if you don't, you have stocks, you have to manage stocks, and when you produce them, it costs something. The games already cost something, and then you have to add the production cost of the physical editions. So if you don't really master like the physical market, it's kind of dangerous to do it by yourself. It's possible, but you have to like do your own connections, like know exactly how to produce the games, what are the different tricks and like things to do and not to do and stuff like that. So we don't have the experience to do that. Some people are doing this perfectly, and so we're happy to work with them.
Are you a collector yourself?
Not really. But now I'm starting to like get the feeling, because for example on my Xbox I have like 300 games. And so I have like this huge, I'm like, oh, that's nice, I have so many games, you know. And I'm like, yeah, but it's like on a screen and like I don't have it somewhere, you know. So I don't know, maybe one day I will say like, wait, I'll make the list, you know, I'll just buy everything I have, you know, like to have it physically. But yeah, I totally get the thing, you know. But no, I'm not really like a collectionist myself.
So what is your personal opinion on physical releases then?
I think it's awesome. I mean, like, some people really like it, and it's cool that we can provide it to them. And also, it's so cool to work on these, like, tangible things, you know, that you can hold in your hand and smell them, you know, and, like, it's nice. And the way we work with Limited Run Games or Arc System Works is, like, trying to find the best, like, you know, things to do, like booklets or posters or what did we do, like you know, like for Wonder Boy we did like this old school kind of like Master System style collector box. So that kind of stuff, you know, it's awesome to work on that, and it's awesome to see people unboxing those and like, wow, that's awesome, you know, like I really like it.
So, obviously, you're here to promote Windjammers.
Yes.
A very great game for the Neo Geo.
Yes.
We have just had the pleasure to play it. It's
awesome.
Really great. So, what are the special features that will be in this port of yours?
So, like always, we're bringing it the way it used to be. So, we're trying to really do an arcade-perfect emulation of the game so that people really find the same feeling playing on console. So you can also play with sticks if you have like PS4 sticks. You can play with the controller. We added some filters so you can have all kinds of different experience according to your like you know, style and the way you like to play. But the main thing that we did for Windjammers and the things that made the most sense when we started to work on it was to have online multiplayer and very competitive online multiplayer, not just like. You know, like a custom match with a friend and that's it. We wanted to have something like we have matchmaking, leagues, rankings, because we think it has a lot of potential for esports. The French community is already like crazy about this game and they're so good at it. So we know it has the potential to be one of, you know, like an esport game. So that's what we're really pushing. That's what took us a long time. It was our first time doing that. And we wanted to have something very seamless, very nice experience where you just like push the button three times and you're searching for a match. So yeah, that took kind of a long time, but now we're kind of happy with the results.
Can we expect a physical release for this game?
There are good chances.
Okay. That's nice. So do you have any other projects in the pipeline right now which you want
to
talk about?
But I can't talk about it.
Okay.
But it's we're working right now on three different productions.
Mm-hmm.
One is a sequel and two are like adaptations of our already but very very big license. So
Okay, that sounds promising. Okay, then thank you very much
for your
time.
Thank you.
And enjoy the rest of Gamescom.
Thank you, I will.
Bored of playing the same old sports and not having any fun?
Windjammers!
Discover Windjammers! That's right, Windjammers is an awesome fast-paced game where you throw flying discs at your opponent to score points! Just catch the flying disc and throw it really hard! It's crazy fun and super easy. You can even do super throws. Get blown away by its incredibly realistic graphics thanks to 330 megabits of pure power. It's not just beautiful, it's super beautiful. With the new internet technology of the future, you can now play Windjammers with your friends anywhere, anytime. Too strong for your friends? Try the new rank mode and challenge the best jammers in the world to become number one! So, what are you waiting for? Call your parents and get Windjammers now!
Win-
Windjammers. When you buy the game, you'll have not one, but two Windjammers to play on your PlayStation 4 or PlayStation Vita for only $14.99. Get this deal now!
Side effects may include friendship termination, excessive bragging, mullet haircut, and procrastination.
Ja, das ist doch richtig geil, ne? Also dank Dotemu und anderer Firmen, die mit verschiedenen Publishern zusammenarbeiten, gibt es eben die Möglichkeit, kleinere Spiele oder Spieleklassiker eben auch einer heutigen Spielergeneration verfügbar zu machen und das Ganze eben auch in physischer Form. Und das finden wir sehr, sehr geil. Jetzt ist es so, dass solche Spiele natürlich häufig in limitierten Auflagen veröffentlicht werden. Und so ist es auch morgen mit Windjammers. Und zwar geht jetzt Limited Run Games morgen an den Start und haut 3800 PlayStation 4 und 3000 Vita-Kopien von Windjammers auf den Markt. Und obwohl wir wissen, dass das immer ein bisschen umstritten ist mit diesen limitierten Auflagen und ja, ne, Limited Run Games ist da ja nun mal ein sehr populärer Vertreter. Obwohl wir das wissen, feiern wir das natürlich hart, weil, Freunde, es ist eben Windjammers und Windjammers ist einfach nur geil. Und wir werden uns da morgen mit Sonnenbrille ins Getümmel stürzen, ja, und versuchen uns da Windjammers-Kopien zu sichern. Und ja, das war uns einfach heute mal ein Video wert. Bei der Gelegenheit haben wir gedacht, können wir das Interview von der Gamescom nochmal in Gänze raussemmeln. Wir hoffen, es hat euch gefallen. Es war ein bisschen informativ und auch mal ein bisschen was anderes. Dankeschön an Commander Dennis für das Interview, für die Fragen, die du gestellt hast. Dankeschön auch nochmal ganz besonders an Dotemu und an Cyril Lombert für die Zeit auf der Gamescom. Danke, dass wir euch besuchen durften und danke auch, dass ihr uns die Fragen so ja, ausführlich und ehrlich beantwortet habt. An dieser Stelle melden wir uns ab. Wir sehen uns morgen im Internet, wenn wir uns zu Windjammers bestellen. Bis dann, liebe Freunde. Ich würde sagen, letztes Wort, Raketenwurf.